You know that I have set up the headquarters of the Southeast Asia Command in Singapore in order to be in the center of the Southeast Asia Theater. My responsibility here is limited to the military tasks of preventing famine and to restoring order and the essential framework of peaceful administration, which was destroyed by the Japanese. But these tasks, restricted though they are when compared with the activities of civil government, are those which are the most vital to the people. I think you all realize, as well as we do, that for the time being, many of the shortcomings and hardships which still exist are inescapable. As a result of 6 years of world war, there is a world shortage of commodities and worldwide shortage of shipping. So if the material improvement in conditions here in Malaya is slow in coming about, this is entirely due to circumstances of a worldwide nature. The allocation of essential foodstuffs in this theater is of course decided far away from here by the combined food boards of the United Nations. I have made it my business to ensure that Malaya gets as large a share of commodities and transport as possible. And I am glad to be able to tell you that 25,000 tons of rice arrived in Malaya in the latter half of December, and a similar quantity is expected in January. Moreover, in response to our vigorous and repeated representations, the Combined Food Board has recognized that this is not enough to meet Malaya's full needs. And they have now agreed to relieve our critical situation by allotting an additional 60,000 tons of flour. Provided shipping can be made available, this quantity is expected to reach Malaya in installments between January and the end of March. Meanwhile, I am confident that the troops in Singapore and in Malaya generally are determined to be as cooperative and helpful as they can, and to reduce the call on the foodstuffs and commodities in the country to the absolute minimum by patronizing their own canteens and service shops. To the citizens of Singapore, I have a few words to say in particular, since it is on you that the main inconvenience of the presence of large bodies of troops falls at the present time. I think you know that in addition to the headquarters of the Southeast Asia Command, those of the Allied Land Forces and of the Allied Air Forces in Southeast Asia, as well as advanced headquarters of the East Indies Fleet, have been set up in your city as well. This, as I do not think I need tell you, has constituted a serious problem of accommodation. On our return, I gave instructions that the fewest possible buildings should be requisitioned and there should be the least possible dislocation in the life of the town itself. I hope you will agree that these instructions are being carried out as well as can humanly be expected. Even so, I realize that many cases of hardship are at present being inflicted by the occupation of civilian accommodation by the services. I can assure you, however, that as fast as our military commitments in Southeast Asia are reduced, so will our claims be reduced on the civilian accommodation in the city. It only remains to tell you that I am determined to see the problems I have outlined above are tackled energetically and successfully, and that civil government is restored to Malaya at the earliest opportunity. I shall now present British campaign stars to the leaders of the guerrilla forces. We are gathered together here today to honor the leaders who symbolize the magnificent struggle which the people of all communities in Malaya put up during the war. I know how proud you all are of these men and of the resistance movement which they led. We of the United Nations, who were engaged in joint warfare with the enemy outside Malaya, are grateful for the help which the people of Malaya gave to the common cause by harassing the Japanese within Malaya itself. This occasion gives me not only the opportunity of paying tribute to their heroism, but also an opportunity of speaking to the people of Malaya personally and in the name of the Southeast Asia Command.
Lim Chang同志。
There was a big gallery at the Tam O'Shanter Golf Club in Chicago.